Hello friends, welcome to the channel Create Your Wealth. With this, we reach to the chapter 4 of the Dhandho framework or the Dhandho Investor. Mittal Dhandho. Bordering Pakistan in Rajasthan, the most colorful state of India, and Marwar is a small district within that state. The Marwaris are regarded as many as being the very best practitioner in the art of doing Dhandho. Their amazing Dhandho endeavors in many cases leave the Patels in the dust. In the 2005 Forbes ranking, the wealthiest human being on this planet was Bill Gates, followed by Warren Buffett, took their usual hot two spots. But nipping to their heels at number three was a Marwari entrepreneur, Lakshmi Mittal. Mittal, from a standing start with a virtually nothing 30 years ago, has a net worth over $20 billion today. He began his Dhandho journey at about the same time that Mr. Bill Gates did. As we know, Bill invested his energies into an industry that offered among the highest return on the invested capital. He took few engineers together, created MS-DOS and Microsoft Word, and then sold hundreds and millions of copies. Let's investigate the amazing economics at work. A single copy of Microsoft Office is sent to the Dell. They load it onto Dell PCs. Each time Dell loads an official copy onto their machine, they send Raymond Washington a few hundred dollars. There are hundreds of millions of copies made all over the planet, yielding to billions and billions of dollars every year for Microsoft. The return on invested capital is out of sight. The gross margin is approaching 100%. What is amazing about Lakshmi Mittal's Dhandho journey is that he invested all his energies and tiny capital base in an industry with a terrible economics. Steel mills. Unlike Microsoft, in steel mills, you have no control over the selling price of the finished product, and you have no control over the cost of the raw material. Steel mills are very capital intensive creatures. If that wasn't a toxic enough cocktail already, the workforce is usually unionized. The steel industry have been one of the worst places to invest capital in the past 30 years. It is no wonder that all over the globe, the players in the space have encountered tremendous pain and large number have ended up bankrupt. Mittal started in 1976 with one single small undescriptive steel mill in Indonesia. Despite having all the odds stacked against him, he ended up creating one of the largest and the most profitable steel industry in the planet. More important for him, he ended up with a net worth of $20 million and it's still growing. How did he do it? There's a simple one-word explanation, Dhandho. Take the example of the deal he created to take over the gigantic Karmat steel works at Kazakhstan. The company had stopped paying the workforce because they were bleeding red ink. They had no cash. The plant was in the verge of closure with the sovereign manager forced to barter the steel for the food for its workers. The Kazakh government was glad to hand Mr. Mittal the keys of the plant for nothing. Not only Mr. Mittal retained the entire workforce and ran the plant, he paid all the outstanding wages, and in the next 5 years, he turned the business into a thriving business with a gushing cash. The workers and the town folks literally worship Mittal as the person who saved their town from collapse. Now comes the next story of Mr. Mittal. The same story was again repeated with the Siddhik steel plant at Romania. The Mexican government handed him the keys of Sibelcel mills for $220 million in 1992. It had costed Mexican $2 billion to build the plant, getting dollar bills at 10 cents or less. This is applying the Dhandho. Mittal's approach has been to get a dollar worth of assets with less than a dollar. And then he applied his secret sauce of getting these mills to run extremely efficiently. The people who founded Google, Oracle, Cisco, and Intel were all very talented, but they had huge tailwind propelling their net worths into the stratosphere. They all focused on business with amazing economics and a very high return on the invested capital. Amazing it is. Mittal, facing a massive headwind, who was having a higher net worth than all of them. The Dhandho framework helped him triumph to all the way to the Forbes 400 in the top 3 position. And as we learn before we are done, both the guys ahead of him were the true practitioners of fine art of Dhandho. Whether you hail in Seattle, Oklahoma, or Marwar, the Dhandho framework to the business pretty much ties all together. The final note on the Marwadis and their ingrained Dhandho ways. Recently, I was at a dinner with a good Marwadi friend of mine, and I asked him how the stereotypical Marwadis approach their invested capital in a venture. He said, quite without any hesitation, that Marwadis are business people, even only with a fifth grade education in the school, simply expect that all their invested capitals will be returned in the form of dividends with not more than 3 years. They expect that after having forgotten their money back, their principal invested continues to be worth at least what they invested in. They expect these are ultra low risk bets. Now folks, there is a really good stuff. They don't teach this in Harvard Business School. If you simply use this Marwadi formula before making any investments, let's be assured of two things. Number one, you would like to quick pass on your investment amounts offered to you. Two, starting with a very little capital and after a few decades, you will be very wealthy. Enough said. Now let's come to my story, Transtech Dhandho. This is the story of the author. To add to the flavors of the Dhandho, let's examine my own Dhandho experience. When I found my first business, Transtech, I was virtually no money. I've had only $30,000 in my 401k retirement account at T-Labs and $70,000 available on my different credit card limits for the number of credit cards that I had signed up in the anticipation of starting my own business. I researched the US bankruptcy law and I found that there was no erroneous. If the business went south, I would be unable to recover my debts and I would declare myself as a personal bankruptcy and start all over again. It was a very similar situation of Papa Patel. There wasn't much downside because there wasn't much to lose. Also, when I resigned, my boss told me that I would like to have you back anytime. And they were likely to give me a decent rise as well. All I had to lose was $30,000 in my 401k retirement account. I was all 25 years old. The last thing I was concerned about was depleting my retirement assets. I incorporated Transtech in February 1990 while continuing to work at Telabs. I took half day off vacation time whenever I had a client sales call. I used to work on the business at home in the morning from 6:30 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. at work during the day and again work on my own business in the evening from 6 p.m. to midnight. I had a paycheck coming in and very little in the way of business expenses. When I had my first client and the revenues were over $200,000 a year in the bag, I resigned. If you look at the approach taken, it was a zero risk approach. The only downside I had was the possible loss of my $30,000 in the 401k account. The upside was enormous, easily several million dollars. The Visa, the MasterCards, and my venture capitalists funding the rest of it. I was single at that time. There was no family to worry about. Many lunches and dinners back were compromised for a simple Subway sandwich. My expenses were pretty low. I considered staying at Telabs to be a risky proposition. I thought if I just stayed at the company, I would likely to be boring and slow corporate path. If I wake up again at the age of 35 or 45 and decide to go off my own, it would be much more complicated. I would likely have a wife, kids by then, which would make it harder for me to break loose and make any risk-free bet. Being 25, single, I was available to take at least one risk-free bet. My game plan was very simple. I had an arbitrage-based business model. The value proposition was leveraging the India's deep expertise, available talent on the client-server computing to satisfy the deep shortage of the talent in the Midwestern United States. I had $100,000 of capital available to me, the $30,000 from the retirement account and $70,000 from the various credit card limits. The business has already started producing revenues and some profits by the time I resigned from Telabs. I knew that with the first two customers on board, generating real revenues and profits, the downside was very limited. It was classic again. Heads I win, tails I don't lose much. Transtech scaled up nicely. In 1996, I was recognized as the top 500 companies in my country, one of the 500 fastest growing company in United States. As revenue went from nothing to over $20 million annually in the next 10 years, the business never took a dime from outsiders for the capital. Cash flow provided all the capital growth and then some. Cash has always been very tight as I was a growing company with rapidly reinvesting all the capital that was scaling up. In 1991, I found a terrific banker, Mr. Tom. He liked our story. He paid off all the credit cards, got us off the very expensive, factoring the receivables that were in the line. I was doing this to bring as much cash as possible and as quickly as possible. And this took Transtech set up for a hugely cheaper line of credit base in our Princeton's receivable. We did sell some of our assets for about $2 million in 1994, which made me feel rich for the first time. And then the entire business was sold in the year 2000 for several million dollars. The $30,000 invested got me more than 150 times the return over the next 10 years. The annualized return was well over 65%. I went from a salary of $45,000 a year when I quit my job to consistently having a salary of $300,000 a year for the next few years. The magic word is dhando. Baby, the huge upside with virtually no downside. It is a classic. Heads I win and tails I don't lose much. This is the kind of bet we all believe in. I would be continuing with the next thing on Dhandho framework. Please stay connected. Share this videos with your friend and on your